C. Nikki, and happy Taco Tuesday, y'all. Y'all, for today, we're going to make some enchiladas, some beef enchiladas, y'all. And it's going to be thebomb.com, girl. Okay. I got some oil, some avocado oil heating up in this pan. And what I'm going to do to start off now, hold on, look at me. You ain't got to put these onions and red peppers in there. I'm just being a little extra, okay? So I'm going to cook up some vegetables first. My pan ain't real hot because you hear it ain't sizzling. But it's going to get hot in a second. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and cook these up. And also, y'all, I'm gonna use 2 pounds of ground beef. I got some enchilada, red sauce, mild in here. Okay? But it's going to be real easy and simple once this pan heat up. Because I thought it was already heated up, but it wasn't. But once it heat up, I'm going to cook this up. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the vegetables out of this pan and put the ground beef. And also, what I'm going to put in my ground beef, I'm going to use 2 packs of the taco seasoning. I'm going to use 2 packs of these. Because I'm using 2 pounds of ground beef. Okay? Or you can either make your own homemade taco seasoning if you want to. That's extra to me. You know, it's Tuesday. Ain't nobody trying to, you know, do all that. You know. It's Happy Taco Tuesday. We ain't trying to, you know, act like it's Sunday and cook gourmet and junk, okay? So we just going to use these 2 packs of taco seasoning that they made for us at Walmart, and we're gonna deal with that. But I'm gonna go ahead, when this skillet get this frying these vegetables up, I'm gonna go ahead and let this fry, and I'm gonna come back when I put this ground beef on. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, y'all, I'm back. Okay, I already took the vegetables out, see that there? I'm gonna go ahead and put that in this meat. The meat is not all the way done yet. We're going to go ahead and put that in there so it can marinate with the seasons. Okay? And I'm going to put them 2 packs of taco seasons in I told y'all about. Them taco packs. Here you go if you forget. See that? Put that in there. Ooh. Y'all going to have a taco Tuesday today, or you just eating just anything? I mean, I ain't mean like it, like anything, but you know, are you just gonna cook whatever? Or some TV dinners or something. Or some bologna sandwiches. Girl, ain't nothing wrong with a good old bologna sandwich. Good old bologna sandwich. Throw some pickles on that thing and some cheese. Girl, I got my mouth watering. My bad water. I like mayo and mustard on my bologna sandwich. And I want my bologna sandwich almost burnt. I want my bologna sandwich almost burnt. Real close to burnt. I'm gonna put a little water. Put a little water in here. And I'm just gonna let this finish cooking together. And we halfway through this thing. We almost through. Go ahead and turn your oven on and preheat it to like 350. Preheat your oven to like 350. And we're going to do this thing. Ooh, girl, you made me mess up. You made me mess up, girl. Throwing off the meat and junk. Girl, what you made me do? Took some of that pound away. Okay, let me fix that. All right, let me stir this in real good. Stir it in, let it finish cooking. I'm gonna let that cook together. And like I said, y'all don't have to put those peppers and onions in. I'm just doing it, okay? You can omit that, okay? You can omit it. All right, and I'm going to be back. I'm going to let this cook together. Finish cooking and simmering. I'm going to be right back, okay? Okay, y'all, we back. Okay. We're going to put some of this enchilada red sauce in this pan right here, this casserole dish. Put some of that down first. Boom. Just spread it around. Okay. All right. Now we're going to start putting it together. Got me a tortilla right here. I'm going to put some of the meat mixture I made right in here. Like so. Okay. And I got some cheese right here. This is triple cheese and some fiesta cheese mixed together. But you can use whatever your favorite cheese is. Put some on there. Okay. And then we're just gonna roll it up. Uh-oh. It's okay if some fall out the side. And we're just gonna sit it in there like that. Okay. Move that off there. Then we're gonna get another one and do the same thing. Put some meat mixture in there. Like that. Put some of that cheese on there. Some of that cheese like that. And then we're just gonna fold it over. Like that. And then put it in the thing. See that? See that, girl? It's easy. It's easy. Okay. I'm gonna do one more on camera, then I'm just gonna finish it up off camera. Put a scoop in there like this. You see it? Put some cheese. Like that. And you just scoop it over. Like that. Okay. I'm going to be right back. I'm going to finish the rest of these, okay? And show you what we're going to do next. Okay, y'all. I got them all fixed up. Now, what you want to do now is take some of that enchilada sauce and pour some over the top. Pour some over the top as much as you want. I'm not going to drown mine in it, though. Just a... Well, I guess if you call it drown, I don't know. Okay. Then, what I'm going to do is, you don't have to do this step. Usually, people just put some cheese on top of there. But, I'm going to put some of my meat mixture on the top. Not all of it, just a little bit. Okay. Like so, just a little bit. Okay, and then we're going to put the cheese. We're going to put some of the cheese on top. And what we're going to do, like I said, go ahead and preheat your oven to 350. Preheat your oven to 350. And we're going to put some aluminum foil on top of this thing. And we're going to let it cook in there for about 20 minutes. And then take the aluminum foil off. And we'll probably put it in about 10 more minutes. Okay. Like that. Okay. And I'm going to put this aluminum foil on it. And we're going to put it in the oven. I'm going to be back, okay? Okay, y'all. Just took this out the oven. And that's how it looks right now. Looks good, good. Looks good, good. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and put this back in the oven for about 10 more minutes just to get that cheese nicely. You know that, get that cheese like that. So, I'm going to go ahead and put this back in the oven about 10 more minutes. Oh, but I mean, if you like it like this, or, you know, you can, you know, go ahead and take it out because everything is done basically. But I'm just gonna put it back in the oven just to get the cheese a little crisp on that thing. Okay, I'll be right back. But when I come back this time, y'all, I'm gonna show you how it look plated. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, y'all, I'm finished with this beef enchilada, and your girl outdid herself. I'm trying to tell you, the thing is thebomb.com. Check these beef enchiladas out, girl. I put a little lettuce on that thing, cause that's how I'm gonna eat them. Put a little lettuce on it, and don't forget that little sour cream. Look at the sour cream action. Look at that sour cream action. Ain't she cute, girl? Not only the beef is on the inside of that thing, she on the outside too. Yes, she is. She cute. She cute. Look at her. Just look at her. Taste a little bit. I give you a little bit. Just taste a little bit. Get that corner piece. Get the corner piece. Okay, that's all you get, girl. That's all you get. Don't be trying to be greedy. You ain't other people how. But look. Y'all, thank y'all so much for tuning in on Taco Tuesday. I'm so hyped up today, y'all. I don't know why. But thank you for tuning in on Taco Tuesday. It's beautiful outside. I hope y'all having a wonderful day. I hope y'all making y'all some good old tacos, nachos, burritos, whatever, quesadillas, whatever. I hope y'all having a good time with each other. And I love y'all. Don't forget, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. Most of all, please hit that like button. It don't take that long. Just hit that thumbs up. Hit that like button. Share this thing on your social media, whatever you own. If you're on the church board, if you're on the student council ministry, whatever you own, just share this thing. Share this thing. Also, make sure you comment. I like to see y'all comments out there. And I love y'all. Please stay safe out there. I know they saying they're finna come out. You know, we're finna be done with all the, you know, COVID stuff. But just still, please stay safe out there so we can have a good time this summer. And I love y'all. And I'm going to see y'all again next time. Bye-bye.